Good morning, students. Myself, G.C. Mallikarjun Swami, Associate Professor of Zoology, Kalpathuru First Grade Science College, Tip 2. Today, I would like to discuss or present some of the slides on the topic Sericulture for 3rd B.Sc. CBZ students, Paper 7, Applied Zoology, prescribed by Tumkur University. The contents of the topic include brief introduction to sericulture, aspects of sericulture, sericulture as an agro-based industry, species of silkworm, mulberry and non-mulberry silkworm with their scientific name, food plant, type of silk produced, and geographic distribution, races of silkworm, brief account of mulberry cultivation. Let me begin with brief introduction to sericulture. Under this heading, I would like to touch upon definition for the term sericulture, early history of sericulture, sericulture industry at present. Definition for the term sericulture. Sericulture is an applied branch of zoology, the science of rearing silkworm or the biology of rearing silkworm in order to obtain raw silk for commercial purpose is known as sericulture. With this, now we'll pass on to early history of sericulture. Historical evidence reveals that the silk was first discovered by Chinese, and from there the silk industry spread to other part of the country. According to Western historians, the secret of mulberry cultivation entered India through Tibet. The cultivation of mulberry and domestication of silkworms were first began in the regions of Brahmaputra and Ganges. But according to some Indian scholars, the silkworms were first domesticated in the foothills of Himalaya. According to Sanskrit literature, certain kinds of wild silkworms or non-mulberry silkworms were cultivated in India from the ancient time. Sericulture industry at present. Nowadays, sericulture has become an important cottage industry or agro-based industry in many parts of the country like China, Japan, India, USSR, Korea, Brazil, and France. China is the number one country in the world as far as the production of the silk is concerned. China produces nearly 150,000 metric tons of raw silk. India is the second largest silk producing country in the world, and India produces nearly 26,000 metric tons of raw silk or mulberry silk, and it also produces nearly 9,000 to 10,000 metric tons of non-mulberry silk. In India, the silk is produced from following five states like Jammu and Kashmir, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, and Karnataka. North Bangalore is being called Silk City in Karnataka. Sericulture has following three aspects or branches. Moriculture. It deals with the cultivation of mulberry food plants like Morus alba, Morus indica, and Morus levigata. Silkworm biology. It deals with the rearing of silkworm. Silk technology. It deals with the reeling of silk from the cocoon. Moriculture and silkworm biology are agricultural in nature, whereas silk technology is industrial in nature. Sericulture as an agro-based industry. Sericulture is basically an agro-based industry. The product of this agro-based industry is silk, which is being described as queen of textiles. Sericulture is considered as agro-based industry because of following facts. Sericulture is considered as cottage or agro-based industry because it provides employment to rural people with a very low capital investment. Sericulture industry is spread over nearly 52,500 villages in India, providing employment to 9 million rural Indians. Moriculture and silkworm biology are agricultural in nature, provide employment to all the members of the family. Silk technology is industrial in nature, provide employment to rural people, including the youths. Sericulture can be taken up as self-employment, for which all the financial institute like bank provide financial assistance. Silk industry is an export-oriented industry. Indian silk is being exported to many countries, thereby India earning crores of rupees as foreign exchange. India is earning nearly $250 to $300 million annually. A villager or a farmer or an agriculturist with 1 acre of land can earn around 40,000 to 50,000 rupees per year if he follows scientific method of mulberry cultivation. Apart from all these activities, sericulture also includes various other activities such as reeling, twisting, weaving, drying, printing, and even marketing. All these activities provide employment to rural Indians. By considering all these facts, sericulture can be considered as an agro-based industry. Species of silkworm. Basically, we come across two species of silkworm, namely mulberry silkworm and non-mulberry silkworm. Mulberry silkworm. The silkworm which feeds on mulberry food plants such as Morus alba, Morus indica, Morus levigata are called mulberry silkworm. The scientific name of mulberry silkworm is Bombyx mori. The silk produced by mulberry silkworm is called mulberry silk, which is the finest quality silk in the world. Non-mulberry silkworm. The silkworm which feeds on non-mulberry food plants such as Terminalia species, Resinus communis, and Machelous bombycina are called non-mulberry silkworm. The silk produced by non-mulberry silkworm is called non-mulberry silk. Non-mulberry silkworms are wild varieties and there are more than 500 species. Non-mulberry silkworms are polyphagous. The term polyphagous refers to the silkworm or an insect which feeds not only on the primary food plant but also feeds on number of secondary as well as tertiary food plants. The term monophagous refers to the silkworm or an insect which feeds only on the primary food plants. Non-mulberry silkworms, for our convenience sake, classified into Tussah silkworm, Eri silkworm, Muga silkworm, Oak silkworm, and Giant silkworm. Mulberry and non-mulberry silkworms with a scientific name, food plant, type of silk produced, and geographic distribution. Mulberry silkworm. The scientific name of mulberry silkworm is Bombyx mori. It feeds on food plants such as Morus alba, Morus indica, Morus levigata, Morus serrata, Morus nigra, Morus lotifolia, and Morus rubra. The silk produced by mulberry silkworm is called mulberry silk. Mulberry silk is the finest quality silk in the world. Mulberry silkworms are found distributed all over the country. This slide depicts the photograph of mulberry silkworm Bombyx mori. This slide depicts the photograph of mulberry food plants such as Morus alba and Morus indica. In the previous slide, we learnt about non-mulberry silkworm. Non-mulberry silkworms are those which feeds on non-mulberry food plants such as Terminalia species, Resinus communis, Machelous bombycina, etc. Non-mulberry silkworms are wild varieties and there are more than 500 species. For our convenience sake, the non-mulberry silkworms are classified into Tussah silkworm, Eri silkworm, Muga silkworm, Oak silkworm, and Giant silkworm. Tussah silkworm. The scientific name of Tussah silkworm is Antheria myelata. It feeds on food plants such as Terminalia tomentosa, Terminalia arjuna, Terminalia cebula, Terminalia bellerica, Shreya robusta. The silk produced by Tussah silkworm is called Tussah silk. The Tussah silkworms are found distributed in Bihar, Orissa, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, and West Bengal. Eri silkworm. The scientific name of Eri silkworm is Phyllosoma resini. It feeds on food plants such as Resinus communis, which is more commonly called as castor plant. Eri silkworm also feeds on kesaru and tapioca. The silk produced by Eri silkworm is called Eri silk. Eri silkworms are found distributed in Bihar, Assam, Manipur, and Meghalaya. Muga silkworm. The scientific name of Muga silkworm is Antheria assamensis, and it feeds on food plants such as Machellus bombicina, Jujubus jujuba, and Michaelia champaca. The silk produced by Muga silkworm is called Muga silk. Muga silkworms are found distributed in Assam, Meghalaya, Arunachal Pradesh, Mizoram, and West Bengal. Oak silkworm. Based on the distribution, there are three species of oak silkworm. All the three species of silkworm generally feeds on the leaves of oak tree and produces a silk which is said to be oak silk. Antheria perini is generally found distributed in China. Antheria emami, generally found distributed in Japan. Antheria proli is generally found distributed in Himalaya, Northeast India, especially Manipur. Giant silkworm. The scientific name of giant silkworm is Attacus atlas. It feeds on the leaves of citrus tree, cinnamon tree, and mango tree. The silk produced by the giant silkworm is called Phagara silk. The giant silkworms are generally found distributed in Malaysia as well as in India. This slide depicts the photograph of Tussa silkworm Antheria mileta, food plant Terminalia arjuna, and Tussar silk. This slide depicts the photograph of Eri silkworm Phylosomia resini, food plant Resinus communis, and Eri silk. This slide depicts the photograph of Muga silkworm Antheria assamensis, food plant Machellus bombicina, and Muga silk. This slide depicts the photograph of oak silkworm Antheria perini, leaves of oak tree, and oak silk moth. This slide depicts the photograph of giant silkworm Attacus atlas, leaves of cinnamon tree, and giant silk moth. Races of silkworm. The term Holtenism in biology refers to number of generations of an organism in a year. Holtenism is under the control of genes. Holtenism is also influenced by light and temperature during embryonic development. Holtenism increases or decreases the number of generations in a year. Based on the number of generations in a year, silkworms are further classified into following races. Univolten. It produces only one generation in a year. Example E16. Bivolten. It produces two generations in a year. Example NB7, NB18, NB4D2, CSR2, CSR26, CSR27, and CSR48. Multivolten. It produces more than two generations in a year. Example Pure Mysore race and Vasa Mysore race. Brief account of mulberry cultivation. Cultivation of mulberry food plants is known as moriculture. Mulberry cultivation involves following agronomic practices or agriculture practices. The land which is selected for mulberry cultivation should possess red loamy type of soil with a pH ranging from 6.5 to 7. Land should receive a rainfall ranging from 625 to 2500 meters of rainfall in a year. Land must be properly leveled, plowed, gravel and weeds must be removed. Organic manure like farmyard manure and chemical fertilizer like NPK must be added to the soil in proper proportion. In addition to this, mixture of neem cake, groundnut cake, and compost is added to the soil in proper proportion. For mulberry plantation or cultivation, stem cutting of the rhesus Mysore 5 or M5, Kanwa 2 or K2, mildew resistance or MR2, S13, S32, S34, S36, S52, and S54 varieties are generally used. S13 and S34 are well suited for rain-fed condition, and S36 and S54 varieties are generally suited for irrigated condition. Mulberry stem cuttings are planted in the month of June or July. Mulberry stem cuttings are planted in two ways, namely the row system and the pit system. Row system. This system is practiced in Kola, hence it is also called as Kola system. This system of mulberry cultivation is practiced for irrigated condition. Mulberry stem cuttings are generally planted in parallel rows, and the distance between row to row is called intra-row distance, and it must be 90 cm. The distance between plant to plant is called inter-row distance, and it must be also 90 cm. Pit system. This system is practiced for rain-fed condition. Mulberry stem cuttings are generally planted in a shallow pit with a dimension of 36 inches by 36 inches, and the distance between pit to pit is 24 inches. This slide depicts the photograph of row system and pit system of mulberry cultivation. Intercultivation must be practiced once in a month in order to remove the weeds. Mulberry plants are fed with the water at regular intervals using modern agriculture technique like drip irrigation or sprinklers. Mulberry leaves are ready to harvest within 3 to 4 months of planting. The term harvesting refers to the picking of mulberry leaves from the plant in order to feed the silkworm. Harvesting is generally carried out early in the morning hours between 7 to 9 a.m. and late in the evening hours between 4 to 6 p.m. Harvesting is generally carried out by any of the following three methods, like leaf picking. In this method, mulberry leaves are picked individually from the plant and fed to the silkworm. Branch cutting. In this method, branches with the leaves are cut and fed to the third instar larva. Old shoot harvest. In this method, old shoot of the mulberry plant is harvested and fed to the fourth and fifth instar larva. This slide depicts the methods of harvesting of mulberry leaves, like leaf picking, branch cutting, and old shoot harvest. Generally, fresh mulberry leaves are fed to the silkworm. Mulberry leaves are preserved in storage room. Mulberry leaves are kept in a clean, cool, dark places in wet gunny cloth. Periodic annual pruning must be carried out in the month of June for the vigorous growth of the mulberry leaves. Pruning is carried out by any of the following three methods, like bottom pruning. In this method, mulberry plant is cut at a height of 30 cm above the ground level. Middle pruning. In this method, mulberry plant is cut at a height of about 60 to 70 cm above the ground level. Top pruning. In this method, mulberry plant is cut at a height of 3 to 4 feet above the ground level. Following are some of the references that I have made: Economic Zoology by Vanita Jaswal and Kamal Kumar Jaswal, Economic Zoology by Dr. Jayasurya and Dr. N. Armukam, Economic Zoology by Sagarika Chaudhary, Introduction to Economic Zoology by B.S. Tomar. Thank you very much.